Steve the Tool Man, in the following video, I did make a mistake. On the Rockville site, they claim that the Rockville SS28B is solid in the middle, and there's no need to add sand because they're so solidly built. And they are solidly built. They are, that's for sure. But there is a cavity in the center of them, which I drilled through the top, and you could probably put 20 pounds of sand in, but I put 16 pounds of sand in the center cavity. You know, I called the company. I told them, you know, this is a bonus. I mean, they should advertise that because people like to add lead and atabites and, you know, whatever to their speaker stands. But anyway, so my mistake, they actually, on their site, they say they're solid, but they're not, which is a great thing for audiophiles. Thank you. Steve the Tool Man here, and today's project is I'm going to put sand in my speaker stands. They say that, well, for one thing, I've got grandkids, so I don't want to see them knock over my speaker stands, so I'm trying to weight them down a little bit. I'm going to be putting in a 75% fill. A lot of people recommend that, not filling them all the way, but like 75%, so I'm going to do that. So here's my Rockville SS28s. I think they were $119, something like that, $120. I'm going to fill those with sand. Yeah, here's my Rockville warranty card. So of course, in the instructions it says this is hollow, and of course mine aren't. That's the way my luck goes. So I drilled a hole in the top of it, and it is hollow inside. So it's 25 inches straight down. And so I'm going to put 19 inches of sand in them. Now, I picked this sand up. One of the fellows on the internet, a really sharp guy, much sharper than me, he recommends this. It came from a pet store, Supernaturals Premium Aqua Sand. So I picked that up. I got 20 pounds. I think I paid $27 for that. So I got two of them, so 27 each. So here's my funnel. I'm going to pour it in till I get about 6 1/4 inches from the top of sand. All filled up till it's got 6 1/4. That'll be a 3/4 fill. So this is my second one I'm doing, and I'll show you. I mean, you know, without the sand in there, yeah, they're pretty wobbly. So I used an 1 1/4 drill bit to cut through this, to cut this hole. And after I was done drilling it, I picked it up, turned it over, and shook it, and got all the remnants out. And I took my finger, rubbed it around on the inside, broke up a bunch of little knickknacks, and got them out too. So it's all clean on the inside. Of course, on their website, they show that that this isn't even here. They say this is open, but it's not on mine, at least. I don't know why I got, but it doesn't matter. I mean, you just drill through it, it's no big deal. So I measured this, and there's only 6 pounds left out of 20, so I put 14 pounds in. So I'm just going to use a scale on the next one and put 14 pounds in. I will say, when you're pouring, keep an eye out. This came out of this bag. I don't know what this is, but it came out of the bag. It didn't go down the hole, thank goodness, and I grabbed it. So be aware, you know, keep an eye out for foreign objects coming out of that bag. So this one, I just put the 14 pounds of sand in, and I can tell you, it's hard to push. You know, here, I'll really crank it over, you know. It's not like it was. I mean, the extra 14 pounds really makes a difference. I mean, it's hard to push. Okay. So like the good audiophile I want to be, I marked where my speakers go. I always have them marked so I can just place them back in there if I do any maintenance to them. I'm not sure I'm going to get a lot of sound difference out of this, but I feel better that they're loaded up pretty good. So that the occasional ball thrown at them, or the the grandkid, you know, bumping into them. Hopefully they won't fall over. You know, I got six grandkids, so grandkid proof and dog proof. I got a dog coming over tomorrow too, so I'll let you know how they sound. I'll play a little something here in a minute for you as soon as everything warms up. And here they are all done, back in my system. Hopefully this will grandkid proof it. You know, we're babysitting tomorrow, so we will see. Anyway, Steve the Tool Man, I'm sure I'll be fiddling around with the alignment here, but we'll see. Anyway.
Made me breakfast in the morning when you got home from work. Making plans to travel around the world. Said we'd always put each other first. Old love songs we used to play too. Funny, now I hate you. Now I remember when you called me late at night. I gave you my hours and advice, just trying to fix you and all your daddy issues. But now I don't even miss you anymore. So I want all the tears back that I cried. All the hours spent giving advice on how to write your song. All you did was prove me wrong when you said you loved me. Well, you must have had your fingers crossed. Should've paid attention to my friends telling me how bad it's gonna end. Always giving their opinions. Now I wish I would have listened. I could say I'm sorry, but I'm not. You don't deserve the one thing that you love. And now I remember when you called me late at night. And I gave you my hours and advice, just trying to fix you and all your daddy issues. But now I don't even miss you anymore.
So I'm gonna count that one as a win. I like the way it sounds. It actually, and the way I judge my hi-fi is if after 3 or 4 hours go by and I don't even realize it, and I've been sitting here just listening to song after song, then I'm good. You know, I don't have the greatest ears in the world. I'm trying to learn how to listen better. I close my eyes when I listen. You can really see the whole soundstage up there. But anyway, I think the sand in the speaker pedestals is good. It's gonna it sounds I'm sure it sounds better. Makes the hair on my arm stand up. But and hopefully the grandkids won't go clipping through there, them or the dog. Okay. Steve Toolman, we'll see ya. Thumbs up.